Hey everyone, today I'm going to talk about natural attenuation. And this was kind of fun for me because I am not on the environmental consulting side of things. My work, you know, really does not deal with this, so this was cool for me. So, what is natural attenuation? The Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA, defines natural attenuation as a variety of physical, chemical, or biological processes that under favorable conditions act without human intervention to reduce the mass, toxicity, mobility, volume, or concentration of contaminants in soil or groundwater. These in situ processes include biodegradation, dispersion, dilution, sorption, volatilization, radioactive decay, and chemical or biological stabilization, transformation, or destruction of contaminants. So basically, natural attenuation relies on natural processes to clean up or attenuate pollution in soil and in groundwater. Natural attenuation does actually occur at most polluted sites. However, though, the right conditions must exist underground to clean these sites properly. And if not, the cleanup will not be quick enough or it will not be complete enough. Scientists monitor or test these conditions to make sure that the natural attenuation is actually working and that it is actually happening. And this is called monitored natural attenuation, or MNA. And so basically, when the environment is contaminated with harmful chemicals, nature works in five ways to clean it up. And those five ways are up here on my top picture. So the first one is biodegradation. And this occurs when very small organisms, known as microbes, eat contaminants and change them into small amounts of water and gases during digestion. The second one is sorption, and sorption causes contaminants to stick to soil particles. The sorption does not destroy the contaminants, but it keeps them from moving deeper underground or from leaving the site with the groundwater flow. The third one is dilution. And dilution decreases the concentrations of contaminants as they move through and mix with clean groundwater. The fourth one is evaporation. And evaporation causes some contaminants like gasoline or industrial solvents to change from liquids to gases within the soil. And then if these gases escape to the air at the ground surface, air will dilute them and then the sun will actually destroy them. And then the fifth one right here is chemical reactions. So chemical reactions react with natural substances underground that may convert these contaminants into less harmful forms. And so basically MNA, or the monitored natural attenuation, works best where the source of contamination has been removed. So kind of, for example, you know, any waste that's buried underground, it kind of needs to be dug up and disposed of properly first, or removed using other available cleanup methods. And then this other picture down here, this is kind of the main picture that popped up, and it's a little blurry, but it kind of shows you, you know, the basics of natural attenuation and how it works. So natural attenuation tends to be cheaper than construction and operating, you know, those fancy engineered groundwater systems. And this is actually, some people say that natural attenuation is controversial. And this is because a lot of those environmental advocates, you know, charge that natural attenuation is a little more than an excuse for the industry to avoid the high cost of building cleanup systems. But these costs can range significantly between sites, and this depends largely on the size of the site, the monitoring frequency, the number of monitoring wells within the monitoring network, the contaminant type, and then any modeling or reporting requirements. However, as you know, that site progresses with that MNA, the operation and maintenance costs can be reduced through optimization of that monitoring frequency, the number of monitoring wells, and then the number of analytes. And then, so how long does natural attenuation take? And natural attenuation, it can take, you know, several years up to decades to clean up a specific site. And that actual cleanup time largely depends on, or it depends on a few factors. And so, for example, the cleanup will take longer when there's a higher contaminant concentration or when it's a large contaminated area. And then there's a few site conditions that also will cause natural attenuation to take longer. And those include temperature, groundwater flow, soil type, or anything that provides a less favorable environment for biodegradation, sorption, or dilution. And then these are my sources. Thanks, everyone.